Now if you've got limited screen space on your Mac, like say you're using a MacBook and you really need to use every pixel on the screen for things, like for instance if you're editing a text document, you want to maybe get rid of some of the regular elements, at least have them hide. And you can hide the menu bar and the dock and have them appear only when you need them to give you more screen space. So let's take a look at the dock first of all. So to get to preferences in the dock, you can go to System Preferences and then Dock, or you can control click on the line divider here. Control clicking will give you access to preferences and also quick access to things like turning hiding on. You may already have this turned on. This means the dock kind of slides away and disappears unless you bring the cursor down to the bottom. This means I can actually expand the window size here, have pages go all the way to the bottom of the screen, and then move my cursor down to the bottom and the dock appears over it. I can, in addition to that, go into preferences and I can change the size of the dock. So I can go all the way to the smallest and you can see how small those little icons get. So if I don't want to make the dock disappear completely, I can have it set so that the hiding is turned off, the dock's always there, but it takes up as little space as possible, or maybe some, you know, medium between here. So for instance, maybe something like this might be a little bit better where I can actually see the icons. So it all depends on how much space you want to get back at the bottom. I prefer to have the icons be a fairly decent size but hiding turned on so it goes away and I have that extra space there. Now for the menu bar, if you go into System Preferences and you go to General, there's the ability to automatically hide and show the menu bar. And it acts in a similar way. You can see the menu bar goes away unless I move my cursor to the top of the screen. So now I can expand the pages window to take up the top of the screen and the menu bar will jump down over it. And I have a split second if I want to grab the top of the pages window there and drag it down. So that's a handy way to get that back as well. Now of course you can ignore both of those and simply go with the full screen option for any app. So I'm going to turn hiding off so now the dock is going to take up this space. The menu bar is taking up all that space. But if I click the green button here, I go full screen with the app, I get rid of the menu bar and the dock and they actually behave in a similar way before. Matter of fact, I get more space back because often some elements at the top of the screen of different apps disappear as well. So you can do that. This separates the app also from the main desktop. So I can actually control left arrow back to the main desktop and control right arrow back to pages, or simply click on pages in the dock and it will jump to it. So that's another way to go about doing it, is not to mess with the menu bar or the dock at all, but when you need that extra space, simply go full screen instead of getting rid of the menu bar and dock. So it all depends on how you want to work. Highly customizable, but there is a way to actually get the space at the top of the bottom of the screen back if you really need it on a small screen Mac.